As per their name, they have the two phases. Okay? Everybody aware about that? We already discussed in the first lecture the reduction of doses form. That is the biphasic liquidose form. There is the two types of biphasic liquidose form. That is suspension and emulsion. Suspension and emulsion. So what is the difference between suspension and emulsion? Suspension have solid in liquid medium. Solid in liquid medium. These are insoluble solids. These are insoluble solids. Okay? Because if this solid is soluble, if we go for the solution. But when it will be insoluble, we go for the further another doses form, that is suspension. And the next one is the emulsion. I just briefly explain that what is the difference between both. Okay. Now after that we come to the pharmaceutical suspension. Emulsion is the two immiscible liquid, that is oil or water. Okay, there is two immiscible liquid. You just write down here, two immiscible, that is oil in water. This is the difference between the emulsion and suspension as per their two phases. That we say that is the biphasic, that means solid in liquid, one phase is solid, another phase is liquid medium. Here is the both are two immiscible liquids. So as per suspension, these are the dispersed system. Okay, biphasic dispersed system, the solid is dispersed into the liquid medium. Okay, the solid is dispersed into the liquid medium, and this will be carried out by the suspending agent. So that is the third component we are adding, the suspending agent. Suspending agent in case of suspension. Okay, while in case of emulsion we are using the emulsifying agent. Okay, so we'll start the first is the pharmaceutical solution. So we have the in this category, in this topic, definition, classification, advantage and disadvantage, theory of sedimentation. Okay, that is the under the category of sedimentation, what is sedimentation, what is Brownian movement, electrokinetic properties. And the next one is the flocculated and deflocculated suspension. After that, preparation of suspension. And next is the stability problem and method to overcome. And the last one, the evaluation of suspension. How can evaluate the best suspension? So as per definition, what is the suspension? Okay, this is the dispersed system, referred to system in one substance is distributed into the discrete unit throughout the second substance, that is the continuous phase. So I said that there is the two phase, this is the dispersed system. Why you are seeing dispersed system? Because there is a dispersion of solid into the liquid medium. Okay, dispersed system, that is the first is the dispersed phase, and another one is the continuous phase. We are discussing only the suspension. Okay, so don't confuse, we will take later. So in the case of suspension, there is this is the dispersed system. We are saying this is the dispersed system which has one phase, because we are seeing two phases. Biphasic means two phases. So one phase is dispersed phase, another phase is the continuous phase. In this case, the dispersed phase is the solid. Okay, and the continuous phase is the liquid. And each phase exists in solid, liquid or gaseous state. Okay, these are heterogeneous system consisting of two phases. So as per there is the just a flow chart, that the dispersed system has the word dispersion medium and dispersed phase. Okay, dispersed phase medium will be the aqueous or oily liquid, and dispersed phase is the insoluble solid that I have already said. Okay, the same things will be discussed here. So pharmaceutical suspension is a coarse dispersion in which internal phase is dispersed uniformly throughout the external phase. As per definition, you can define in many ways. Okay, you will say that is the dispersed system which has the two phase, dispersed phase and continuous phase, and explain it. In another way, you can say pharmaceutical substance coarse dispersion. In internal phase, we can say this also the internal or external phase. Internal or external. So this is internal phase is the therapeutically active ingredient is dispersed uniformly throughout to the external phase. Basically, the main things in the suspension that is the particle size of the particles. Okay, insoluble solid particle has the particle size ranges 0.5 to 5 micron, which are maintained uniformly throughout the help of suspending vehicles or suspending agent. Okay, the external phase is generally aqueous, in some instances may be organic or oily for non-oral phase. So there is a type of suspension which are available in the market and we are the daily use preparations like antacid oral suspension. Anti is a very common suspension which are used regularly because most of the patients have the heartburn. Heartburn, that is the acidity. Acidity. In case of acidity, we are using the antacid. Okay. Antibacterial oral suspension because there is so many antibacterial drugs or antibiotics is available. Mostly the problem with antibiotics is the stability problem. Stability problem. So we go for the better way to go for to the suspension. Okay. Because in solution form, it will be degraded. In suspension form, they are used as a reconstituted powder, which are at the time of administration we suspend into the given medium. Another one is the analgesic oral suspension, anti-helminthic oral suspension, anti-convulsant oral suspension, antifungal oral suspension. Okay. Now we come to the advantage and disadvantage of that is the suspension. Main advantage, if you see that there is a numbers of advantage over the solution. First is the suspension can improve chemical stability of certain drug, which I said that the antibiotic are unstable into the aqueous or liquid medium directly. Okay. So we can use into the suspension form. Drug in suspension exhibit high rate of bioavailability than other doses form. As we said that particles which are reduced in a dispersed in a liquid medium in a reduced size, their surface area will be increased. Their surface area will increase, that means their bioavailability will be increased. See? The surface area bioavailability is directly proportional to the surface area. Surface area will be increased and the bioavailability, that means the absorption of drug will be increased. So you can see there is the comparison between these solution. Suspension, capsule, compressed tablet and coated tablet. As compared to the suspension, solution is more absorbing. Okay? But other than capsule, compressed tablet and coated tablet, suspension is better. Duration and onset of action can be controlled. Because suspension can be used into the controlled release also or sustained release. Okay? That is the example is the protamine, zinc, insulin suspension. These are used as a for the control release. Okay. Suspension can mask the unpleasant or bitter taste of drug. Another purpose of the use of suspension is to taste masking. Okay. Most of the drugs are very bitter. Okay. So suspension is a good way of to taste masking of the bitter drug like chloramphenicol. You can see the example chloramphenicol. So there is the always who have the advantage and disadvantage is also there. Okay. So main disadvantage is the physical stability because the suspension is the thermodynamically unstable preparation. Thermodynamically unstable preparation. We discuss what is the thermodynamic in the later. That is the basically the what is the problem with the suspension, that is the physical stability, sedimentation and compaction can cause problem. Why there is a stability? Because the you know that is the if you don't have a good suspension, it will be separated into the two phase. It will be break down into two phase, that is your liquid is separate and your solid is separate. If you don't prepare properly, the solid will be stuck in the base of the your container. stuck into the base of the container and make cake formations, to do the cake formation. And if the suspension is not good, their redispersibility is not possible. So, it is difficult to formulate. Uniform and accurate dose cannot be achieved unless suspension are packed into unit doses formed. Okay. So, what is the, if you see that in case of suspension, there is the two phases, solid into the liquid medium, solid into the liquid medium. This is the solid and this line is the liquid. Okay. What happened after some time, the property of suspension has the, they will be separate into two phase. Separate into the two phase. There will be separated into the two phase. The ideal suspension should be redispersed. It should be, yet it will be separated into two phase after shake well before use. Shake well before use is the labeling. Secondary level of suspension is always mentioned. Why? Because suspension is always shake before use. Because it will be separated in two phase, after shaking it will be redispersed. This is the ideal property of suspension. This will be redispersed. This is the redispersed phase. So, as you know that if the this will be not in this way, what happens? Your accurate dose will be not come out. Okay? So, this point is mentioned here into the disadvantage. Now, we come to the classification of suspension. As per their use journal class, they will be based on the journal class. There is the types of suspension, oral suspension, externally applied suspension and parenteral suspension. The oral suspension, usually the oral suspension we are using so much, paracetamol suspension, antacid, tetracycline, hydrochloride. Other than this one, externally applied suspension, the externally applied suspension, that is the calamine lotion, is the good example of externally applied suspension, because calamine lotion is itself as a suspensive form, suspension doses form, which are used externally. Okay. Other than externally, they are parenteral suspension, that is the use for the injection, use for the injection. So, many antibiotics are available as a suspension to mainly the, they are type of nano suspension which will be administered to the patient. Okay. That is the procaine, penicillin, G insulin, zinc suspension. So, another category of the classification, okay, because classification is your part of your exam, your syllabus, it will become in your exam. Okay. Always the examiner will ask the define the suspension and classify this one. Okay. Or also you can mention the advantage and disadvantage. This will be the short notes will become in your exam. So, on the based on the proportion of solid particle, another classification pattern, that is the dilute suspension which has 2 to 10% weight by volume solid. Like example, cortisone acetate, prednisolone acetate. Another one is the concentrated suspension, that is 50% of the weight by volume of solid, like zinc oxide suspension. So, this category is based on the presence of solid particles, the concentration of the solid particle into your suspension preparation. And another category is the, another is the based on the electrokinetic nature of the solid particle, that is flocculated suspension and deflocculated suspension. Electrokinetic nature of the solid, that means electrokinetic, that means the particles who are distributed into the liquid medium carry the some charge, negative and positive charges. So, they are electrically potentially distributed on that surface of the suspension. So, the stability will be affected by this nature of the your solid. Next is the based on the size of solid particle. First of all, there is the concentration of solid particle, the presence of the how much this is present in your preparation. Now, this is the size of the solid particle, because size is very, very important for the suspension. So, there is a colloidal suspension, that means the less than 1 micron, less than 1 micron is known as colloidal suspension. The suspension having particle size of suspended solid less than about 1 micron size are called as colloidal suspension. Other than another is the coarse suspension. As per their particle size is more than 1 micron. Okay. And the example is the barium sulfate. Barium sulfate is the preparation used for to the diagnostic purpose. Okay. This is it will be used for the diagnosis of the JIT. And another one is the nano suspension. So this nano suspension, according to their particle size, that is the nanogram, 10 nanogram. Okay. Suspension are the size of drug particle is less than 1 millimeter. There is an application of suspension. Basically, what is the purpose of suspension preparation? That is the first is the insoluble or poorly soluble. Okay. So, the drug which are soluble, we go for first priority is your solution. But if it is not soluble, we go for to the suspension. The suspension is usually applicable for the drug which is insoluble or poor soluble, like prednisolone suspension. Okay. Next is the to prevent degradation of drug or to improve stability of drug. Okay. The things which are covered into the advantage, this is the same application of the dosage form. So, there is a degradation of drug because so many drugs like antibiotics which are like oxytetracycline. These are the medicament which are unstable into the normal phase, okay, that is with the in the liquid medium. So, it is better to improve their stability by using the suspension, okay, dosage form. Next is the to mask the taste of bitter of unpleasant drug, that is chloramphenicol palmitate suspension. And suspension can be formulated for topical applications, that is calamine lotion. Okay. So, the application is according to their use, okay, advantage and disadvantage. So, application, if you see the disadvantage of the suspension, the same things will be in their application. Another one is the suspension can be formulated for parenteral application. Control the rate of drug absorption. So, you know that is the suspension, this is the another control release dosage form, where we control the release of the drug. By applying the types of polymer, we are prepared in the form of suspension. Another one is the vaccine as a immunizing agent. So, it is often formulated as suspension like cholera vaccine. X-ray contrast agent, that is the use of as a diagnostic agent. Finally, that is the ideal property of pharmaceutical suspension. So, as I said that this is the ideal property which we require for the suspension. So, you see that is the first is the redispersibility or resuspended. Dispersibility or suspended, that means when we will use it will be, that means when it will be separated into two phase, it will be again redispersed into the one phase at the time of administration. And next is the it should be easy to pour. You always observe that when you decant the suspension from the bottles, it has particular consistency so that they will pour properly. That means not watery or not grittiness. Grittiness, that means there is the type of particles, like you can say feel the particles on your hand or your mouth. And another one, it should have pleasing odor, color and palatability, because this is the palatability means to accept by the patient, good feeling. Basically kya hota hai, dosage form mostly patient hota hai, they don't like, mainly case of pediatric patient, if they are bitter or this is not odor, smell is not good. Because color is also very important for the pediatric patient, they attract to the, there is a orange, strawberry colors, so they attract to the patient, okay, mainly the pediatric kids. And good syringeability, that means when we syringe out from the injection, it will be properly come out. If there is not syringeability, is not good, your needle will be blocked. And it should be physically, chemically and microbiologically stable. Basically, the stability is very important thing for the physically, chemically and microbiologically, that means they don't affected by the microorganism. And chemical stability, that is there is not any chemical reactions to change in their colors, okay. And physically, that means there is a segregation of or the lumps formation of the particle. If the particles will be agglomerate, that is compact with this one, it will be make a big particle, it should not happen. So, this is the ideal property of, now we come to the theory of sedimentation, because these are the very very important things for your suspension part. Okay. If you see the as per their doses from advantage, disadvantage, you see that is very easy, but the theory is very very important for the suspension. The how can it will be sediment, what is the principle will be applied for the sedimentation. So, as per their name, what is the sedimentation? Can you see, can you explain anybody what is sedimentation? I discuss whole topics, what is suspension, what is sedimentation, what is sedimentation? Sedimentation means settle down, that means your particle will go down, this is known as sedimentation. That means ye part, the particles, ye suspension, ye particles hai, they will be slowly slowly come down, it will be settled down. So, ek time ke baad it will be ye baith jayenge yahan pe, it will ye baith jayenge yahan pe aur ye separate ho jayega phase. Isko kya karte hain, isko fir se hum redisperse karte hain. So, sedimentation is very very important point. जो नेचर है आपके पार्टिकल का, उसकी सेडिमेंटेशन, दैट मीन्स का सेटलिंग की प्रॉपर्टी जो है, इट्स वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. इसके लिए आपको स्टॉक्स लॉ फॉलो करना पड़ेगा. एज पर स्टॉक्स लॉ देयर इज अ इक्वेशन विच शो द सेडिमेंटेशन ऑफ पार्टिकल्स, बिकॉज हम क्या कर रहे हैं यहाँ पे, सारे सॉलिड पार्टिकल्स को ही तो पानी उसमें डिजॉल्व लिक्विड मीडियम में डिस्पर्स कर रहे हैं, डिस्पर्स कर रहे हैं, तो आफ्टर सम टाइम इट विल बी सेटल डाउन. जो एक नेचुरल प्रॉपर्टी होती है, आप रेत वगैरह अगर लोगे पानी में डालोगे वो सीधे बैठ जाएगी, बट हमारी सस्पेंशन फॉर्मुलेशन ये होती है कि हम उसमें कुछ ऐसी चीजें डालते हैं जो उस पार्टिकल को उसमें डिस्पर्स करे, उसको बिठाए नहीं, मतलब उसको एक तरह से उसको डिस्ट्रीब्यूट करे पूरे पार्टिकल को हमारे लिक्विड मीडियम में. उसके लिए ही हम सस्पेंडिंग एजेंट यूज करते हैं, उसके लिए ही हम सस्पेंडिंग एजेंट यूज करते हैं. दीज सस्पेंडिंग एजेंट जो होते हैं ज्यादातर सर्फेक्टेंट होंगे या फिर गम होंगे, अकेशिया गम, गम ट्रैकेकैन, टाइप्स ऑफ गम आर यूज फॉर द एज ए सस्पेंडिंग एजेंट. सो देर इज दी वी कम टू द स्टॉक इक्वेशन, स्टॉक्स लॉ इसको कहते हैं, स्टॉक्स लॉ भी कहते हैं. एज पर स्टॉक्स लॉ यू कैन सी देर इज द इक्वेशन V is equal to directly proportional to the D square P and G and inversely proportional to 18 eta. Or it will be write down like this way, 2R square P minus P0 G upon 9 eta. R जो है radius है, particle का size जो होता है, it's very very important. अगर अगर इस equation को देखोगे, जो ये v represent the velocity of sedimentation, rate of sedimentation, v represent the velocity or rate of sedimentation. तो इसमें क्या होता है, जो v है वो है directly proportional to r, r is the radius of the particles, particle का जो size है उसको radius में measure करते हैं. इसका particle size अगर बड़ा होगा तो वो fast बैठेगा, सो ये directly proportional है. और दूसरा क्या है, P जो है डेंसिटी ऑफ द पार्टिकल, एवरी पार्टिकल हैज पर्टिकुलर वेट, एक वेट होता है, एवरी पार्टिकल हैज पर्टिकुलर वेट, लाइक इट विल बी हाई डेंसिटी और लो डेंसिटी, या तो लाइट वेट होगा या हैवी वेट होगा. हैवी वेट होगा वो तेजी से बैठेगा कंपेयर टू द लाइट वेट, तो इनके बीच में जो डिफरेंस होता है दैट इज पी एस पी ओ पी. एक्चुअली दिस इज नॉट एग्जैक्टली पी, दिस इज पॉइज, रिप्रेजेंट द पॉइज. सो देयर इज द डेंसिटी ऑफ डिस्पर्स फेज एंड डेंसिटी ऑफ डिस्पर्स मीडियम. एस जो है डेंसिटी ऑफ डिस्पर्स फेज, सो दिस इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द डेंसिटी ऑफ डिस्पर्स फेज टू द डेंसिटी ऑफ डिस्पर्जन मीडियम. दैट आपका यहाँ पे सॉलिड का जो है डेंसिटी है और ये मीडियम की डेंसिटी है, इसके बीच में जो भी डिफरेंस होता है इसको यहाँ पे पुट करेंगे, दैट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन देम विल बी डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द वेलोसिटी और द रेट ऑफ सेडिमेंटेशन. ओके, उसके अलावा ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स, ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स तो पता ही आपको, कोई भी चीज़ को ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स नीचे खींचती है. ओके, तो ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स ज़्यादा होगा तो सेडिमेंटेशन भी फास्ट होगा. तो आर यू क्लियर दिस इक्वेशन? नेक्स्ट है विस्कोसिटी. विस्कोसिटी इज अनदर फैक्टर विच अफेक्ट द सेडिमेंटेशन, विच अफेक्ट द सेडिमेंटेशन, दैट मीन्स इट विल बी द इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल. अभी तक जो जितने हैं ये डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल थे, ये इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल, दैट मीन अगर ये ज़्यादा विस्कस है तो सेडिमेंटेशन स्लो होगा, कि दैट उल्टा चलेगा, ये अपोजिट, कि अपोजिट नेचर है इसका, ये ज्यादा होगा तो ये कम होगा
और ये कम होगा तो ये ज्यादा होगा.
दैट इज द इनवर्सली, इसको कहते हैं हम इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल. सो दिस इज द स्टॉक्स लॉ. देयर इज सम लिमिटेशन ऑफ स्टॉक इक्वेशन, दैट स्टॉक इक्वेशन अप्लाई ओनली टू द स्फेरिकल पार्टिकल इन ए वेरी डाइल्यूट सस्पेंशन. तो क्या कहता है ये स्टॉक इक्वेशन, जो इक्वेशन जो होता है प्रिंसिपल पे बेस्ड होते हैं, तो सब चीज आइडियल नहीं हो सकती है. तो ये कह रहा है कि इसके साथ लिमिटेशन क्या है, स्फेरिकल जो गोल शेप पार्टिकल होंगे, जो एग्जैक्टली स्फेरिकल होंगे, एग्जैक्टली स्फेरिकल होंगे, उसी पर ये प्रिंसिपल अप्लाई होगा, ये लॉ अप्लाई होगा. ठीक है, एक तो ये है लिमिटेशन. जरूरी नहीं कि सारे पार्टिकल स्फेरिकल हो, कुछ ऐसे भी हो सकते हैं, पार्टिकल के शेप अलग अलग हो सकता है. सो एंड देयर इट शेयर स्फेरिकल पार्टिकल इन ए वेरी डाइल्यूट सस्पेंशन. एक और चीज है, इट विल बी अप्लाई इन टू दी डाइल्यूट सस्पेंशन, दैट इज दी 0.5 to 2 ग्राम पर 100 ml. यूजली क्या होता है, जो लॉ होते हैं दे विल बी अप्लाइड इन टू पर्टिकुलर इन कंडीशन. इन दिस केस दे विल बी डाइल्यूट पार्टिकल विच फ्रीली सेटल विदाउट कोलिजन. ये कह रहा है कि ये सेटल होना चाहिए फ्रीली, जैसे कि हम बॉल डालते हैं तो बॉल जैसे नीचे आने चाहिए एक एक करके, वैसे आना चाहिए, बट ऐसा तो प्रैक्टिकली नहीं पॉसिबल है. सो दिस इज द लिमिटेशन, पार्टिकल विद नो फिजिकल और केमिकल अट्रैक्शन. दैट मीन्स अगर बॉल को डालेंगे तो कुछ आपस में अट्रैक्शन नहीं होना चाहिए. ठीक है, जो बट पार्टिकल का ऐसा नहीं होता, पार्टिकल या तो अट्रैक्ट करेगा या रिपल्स करेगा, दो प्रॉपर्टीज होती है. ये जो नेचर है जो पार्टिकल्स का, रिपल्सन और अट्रैक्शन, ये आपके प्रिपरेशन की स्टेबिलिटी को अफेक्ट करता है. तो आपका प्रिपरेशन स्टैंड जो करेगा, कहते हैं ना कि ये बना रहे सस्पेंशन फॉर्म में, खराब नहीं हो, तो उसकी स्टेबिलिटी को ये फैक्टर अफेक्ट करती हैं.